right, we're gonna have a an action or a live action video here on this texturing of the nose. Now, I've mixed up brown, black, and a touch of white epoxy sculpt, and I added a little more of the black brown mix to it that I used on the eyelids. Now, it's been spread out and built over the scar and whatnot. What I'm gonna do now with this just this damp brush, it's been dampened with rubbing alcohol, I'm just going to start stippling to get a jump ahead on the texturing that will happen with the silicone press pad. Let me take a little more of the alcohol off the brush, make it more of a dry brush, and go on. What this does is two things. It roughs up the surface a bit, and I'm shaping the nose pad as I go. I'm evening it out. Now, come around. Now that one little pad of silicone I made for this side can be worked all over. It will put texture back into the nose. And I may do that live on camera as well, just to kind of enhance this part of the video a little bit. I think no one's ever seen that done before, so I'm gonna do it for you. Now this is gonna set for about, I don't know, 30 minutes, 45 minutes, an hour before I worry about putting a press pad on there, and you'll see how that happens when I get around to it, when I get to it. To get this done, I've sprayed a little Pam cooking spray on the top of my stainless steel work table. I'm going to take an artist brush. I'm simply going to brush some of the non-stick cooking spray onto the little silicone pad. Take the excess off with my finger. Now I'm going to press it into the epoxy. Hopefully I haven't left it too long. We shall see what we shall see. Looking pretty good. And I'm going to reapply it. Fingers blocking the whole thing, I know, but I need to press this into tight, firm contact with the epoxy. I actually dropped it off camera. I spent almost 15 minutes looking for it. That looks real nice right there. That looks real super nice. The reason you need to let it set up really well, because you're putting a lot of pressure to get the impression material, to get the impression from the material into the epoxy. And I'm doing it at the top as well. Let me add a little more of the cooking spray to it. And maybe that will help get it in there a little more. Press real hard. Oh yeah, that is sweet. That looks mighty sweet. Let me get in a little closer. And there we have it. Looks pretty darn good. In fact, it looks real good. That's a good texture. It's a real good texture there. And when it's colored, it'll look even better. And as I'm looking over, I'm moving around in front of it where the camera's stationary, just because it needs to be for focus purposes. I see a nice, nice, super nice little nose pad detail on this guy. It's really worked out well. Okay, I'm going to show you how I did that that groundwork on the base here. It's real simple. I simply take some this plaid brand acrylic paint. You can get this in Michael's, wherever you get your hobby paints from. Flip the top open and squirt a bunch of it onto the base. Spread it around with a brush. You want it to go on thick. Be liberal with the paint. No matter what your ideological or political leanings, put it on liberally. Once you get it on liberally, it's a simple matter of adding the ground cover on top of the paint. Okay, go like so, getting it all around. You don't want it puddled, but you do want it on thick. You don't want to make deep puddles. You want it liberally thick and even. And don't forget to go in the footprints where the otter will stand. And the back of his footprint is done in here, right along here. Well, I don't know how well this is getting in the camera. But the back of the hind part of the footprint is here. Well, this is all going to take the front. And what I'm going to use for my initial groundwork, for my first groundwork covering, is going to be simply re-dried coffee grounds. And these are used coffee grounds that I empty onto a sheet of paper towel and put into an oven, our oven, on like a heat of about 250, 225 or 250. And I leave it in there for several hours. Pull them out and they're dried. Now, with this set up like this, with all this paint, making sure that it hasn't soaked in too much into the mache, you'll know it's not sunk, absorbed in, because it stays shiny. I'm gonna take this re-dried coffee with a spoon. I'm gonna sprinkle it on like so, and like so, all around, wherever it needs to be. I'm going to sprinkle on the coffee, using just the spoon as my distribution tool for the coffee, and like so. You can go as quick or as slow as you want with this. I'm going pretty quick because I'm on camera, and this is under lights, and I don't want it to dry out. You then take your hands and kind of tamp it down into the paint. Your finger, your hands, whatever. Okay, like so. Next, I'm going to vacuum off the excess.
Now what I've got this old stocking pulled over the tip of my little dirt devil, and I'm gonna turn it on and vacuum this up. This will collect it so I can reuse it. See how it collects? Suck in a little more, let it just suck down into the tube, and take some more up. That's a great way to collect your material to pour right back into the container.
I'm going to go ahead and complete this, then I'm going to let it dry overnight. Tomorrow I'm going to come in, I'm going to take some Mod Podge that's been diluted with water, about half and half, and I'm going to spray it onto the surface to lock everything down, and then I will be able to add some actual leaf debris that I collected from outside. And I'm going to crunch that up, and that'll be stuck down into the glue that's going to cover everything. So I'm going to continue this with the coffee ground, with the brown acrylic paint and coffee grounds until it's completely covered.